not working. One, two, three.
It's been a while since you and Robert have toured together. Any nervousness, apprehension?
There's no apprehension whatsoever. I'm waiting for this, you know, bated breath. You know, I can't wait to start getting the whole thing moving. I always get nervous before any show. It's a perfectly healthy thing, because I think it's just adrenaline racing in the body.
At this point in the game, you still get nervous?
Oh, yeah. Really? I'd feel rather uncomfortable if I didn't, I think.
Really?
This keeps the edge going.
Do you really still get nervous?
Oh, sure. Why do you think I do it? Part of the thing is that frightened the hell out of me. And there's so many things to remember. But the most important thing to remember is, you know, we want to have a lot of fun.
I was 1 year old when their first album came out. I'm really pumped. Stairway!
So what are you looking forward to most tonight?
Well, actually, I'm an old Zeppelin fan from years back. So actually, seeing the two of them together is just a thrill for me.
Is there a majority of the fans that want to hear the song exactly like it was on the record?
There probably is an element of the fans that would like to do, you know, to sort of hear that in a sort of nostalgic fashion, possibly, or maybe just to see whether we can do it, you know, sort of note for note from the past. But we never ever did do that. We always changed things around, even, you know, in Zeppelin. So. And also, whenever each album came out, we always tried to tread new ground and new paths. So I think the sheer fact of Robert and I coming back together, for people that were really into us, they really wanted us to try, you know, to get into new things. It's pointless if we got back together to start stepping backwards. We had to step forward.
Would you welcome Mr. Hossam Ramzi and the Egyptian Ensemble?
The whole deal of this is it's quite experimental. That's all you can ever hope for in music, is not to be, you know, a prisoner of your own songs and your own tunes and your own success. And now we've branched out enough that we can make it really a very vivid experience, I think.
What was the highlight?
Definitely the orchestra.
It was a great show, everything went great, but one thing they missed out was Stairway to Heaven Live. That's what everybody's looking for.
I am not happy at all. They didn't even play Stairway to Heaven. What is going on with that?
Stairway to Heaven or no Stairway to Heaven, it can't be top. Stairway to Heaven's a song that they played a zillion times and everybody in the world knows. They wanted to play something new, and that's what they did, and I respect that because that's what they wanted to do. And I came out to see Jimmy Page and Robert Plant, not Led Zeppelin.
When thinking of Australia, some Americans might first think of koalas and kangaroos. But when you arrive in Sydney, there is more to the city after the sun sets. A nightlife that thrives, including a music scene that has produced some notable local bands.
Hello, Cleveland!
How
would you describe Front End Loader?
How it, Front End Loader I'd describe as very Australian, from a great Australian pub rock tradition of making a really, really loud noise and yelling and screaming and taking your shirt off and playing great guitar.
How would you describe the band's sound?
I don't.
I never did. This is the worst question I ever did.
Yeah,
loud pop music.
Yeah, loud pop music.
That's,
we're a rock band, basically.
What's it like doing shows here?
Playing?
What are the crowds like?
Well, it depends on... With us? Well, it's getting better. Set in my car, I'm watching a few kids. Standing on Backstage. I'm knocking it up.
What is it for young people when they come here to Sydney, or if they're living here, what is there to do?
If you're not going out to see a band, they're probably coming in just to go to a pub or to go out clubbing, and the main clubbing is along the Oxford Street stretch.
Street is renowned for being like the Golden Mile, where you have a multitude of gay clubs and gay things to do. There's a great community feeling here.
And there's more. Oxford Street has a variety of cafes and coffee bars. Is this what you normally do on a Friday night?
I'm not into nightclubs at all, so I usually go to a bar and have a drink, or go to a cafe and have a coffee, relax.
Is there anything that we didn't cover that you wanted to say?
Australia.
We love you, mate.
Come to our country.
Yeah.
Silverchair is all we talk about. Always.
When did you personally say you wanted to be in a group?
I didn't really. I was just playing a guitar at Ben's house, the drummer, and I was just playing some songs that really. And I was just mucking around playing the guitar, and he got on the drums, and we just started jamming just for something to do because we were really bored. You think you can keep on going, living like a king? And after a while, we just started writing some songs. Just we didn't ever say, oh, let's be in a band. We said, oh, do you want to jam for something to do, for some fun, if like the surf was and we had no homework or something. So we said, oh yeah, we'll have a jam.
Members of Silverchair were all of 14 years old when they first recorded the demo for Tomorrow. The dark and angry song is the first single from their debut album Frog Stomp and is accompanied by an equally gloomy video shot by MTV alumnus Mark Pellington, best known for Pearl Jam's Jeremy. You go! The Pellington connection may reinforce the Pearl Jam comparisons that Silverchair has already heard, but the band doesn't deny the influence.
At the beginning, I'd say with the Tomorrow EP, I'd say you could see the comparisons there. But now I think we've moved on a bit and gotten a bit heavier and changed a bit. Yeah, I don't think we sound like Pearl Jam or anything like that now.
Teen Trio has also been hit with another Seattle comparison, Nirvana in Pajamas, partly due to lead singer Daniel John's resemblance to a young Kurt Cobain.
We don't particularly like the comparisons to Nirvana because we think that, you know, the music's nothing like them.
Just a lot of people say, oh, he's trying to be Nirvana because we're a three-piece and I've got blonde hair. Stuff like that, they won't say. It's just because the hair is that long and I'm trying to grow, but it won't grow. So I'm just going to keep trying to grow, and if it doesn't grow, I'll just shave my head and be a punk. Put your hands in the air! Put your hands in the air! Yeah!
All right, on the big night, 51st Street really becomes limo lane. All the limousines pour down here. The celebrities hop out and begin to walk in this direction. Now, to get all their hangers on and people like that out of the way, we're going to have somebody from the beach house, like, handing out watches and things like that. So the celebrities will come down here completely unprotected, where they'll be intercepted by our own Allison Stewart. We'll do a quick little interview, and then they'll go past the paparazzi and up the staircase of love. All right, once your average celebutante scales these stairs, which should provide the evening's toughest test for any outfit, they'll be lightly grilled with a small butter sauce by Tabitha Soren and Kurt Loder, who will have to contend with the constant chants of Hootie, Hootie, Hootie from all the fans who will be gathered across the street. And here we are outside the MTV Video Music Award production office, as you see, where the tireless professionals who make this show work like clockwork the way it always has for many, many years now do their business. As you can see, we're answering telephones here. People are refusing to pick up their messages as usual. Many, many people involved in the act of just trying to make this whole thing go, as you can readily see. Look at all the professionals here hard at work. Just dedicated people doing everything possible to make sure that this show goes off completely without a hitch. What's your role here at this fine production?
Control Central.
I see. Now, how many lines do you have going there? Go ahead, you can get that.
MTV production. They hung up. We love
it. We saw Michael Jackson, you know.
You did.
All right, the occasional sound from the music hall reverberating in this beautiful Art Deco grand foyer of Radio City Music Hall. Built in the early 30s, went through a real boom time as a movie house, and then had a few years of unprofitability before it was turned into a concert hall. If you look around, you see beautiful carpet, which indicates a variety of instruments. I think that's a banjo over there, and we've got a guitar here. You can figure it out yourself. Up there, it's 24-karat leaf, I think made from melted-down Ace of Base records. Did you ever come to Radio City Music Hall before you got into the business yourself, as a civilian?
Oh, yeah. I grew up in New York, so my grandmother always brought me to the Easter show and Christmas show, and I used to come see movies here and stuff, yeah.
Remember what movies you saw here?
Yeah, like, you know, Tom Sawyer and all that kind of stuff.
And here is the great stage at Radio City, where so many performers have strutted their stuff. The very first Video Music Awards took place here, hosted, if you can believe it, by Bette Midler and Dan Aykroyd. Number two as well, with Eddie Murphy last year, and now this one. And here's the view that so many of the performers and presenters will see as they come up on this big stage. Growing up, did you have the mystique of Radio City Music Hall in your mind at all? Is this any kind of a factor outside of New York City?
The actual venue here?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of history here and a lot of amazing, spiritual, sort of talented people that have come through here, so it's good to be in this building. Yeah.
Have you met a rock cat yet?
No. Hopefully I will, though, you know.
Years ago, a friend of mine asked me to say some MC rhymes. So
that was then, and this is now.
There's one last thing, the most important of all, that I must tell. You must be born again, my friend, or you're going straight to hell.
Well, what's the general reaction that you get when...